वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। वागर्थाविव सम्पृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ। येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। We have completed Tudadigana. Today we will start Churadigana. Churadi Ganiya Dhatavaha. The 10th Gana is called Churadigana. The first Dhatu being Chur Dhatu. Chur, stay. Therefore, this Gana is called Churadi Ganaha. Churadi Ganadhatavaha.
Samyatam Sharanji.
Yes.
We started some Samprasarana Dhatavaha. Then you said next class we will see.
Samprasarana, we completed in the last class. Tudadi Gana. I mean, in that context, Samprasarana came. Okay.
But you said something, then we can start. You said at the end, we shall complete this and then start.
Which complete what? Samprasarana?
I don't know. Under Samprasarana, we did Homa Agama. After Samprasarana, that time you said something, you said. We should complete this and then start
it. Not clear. Again?
No, after that, we are doing Samprasarana and we started doing Yoma Agama Jatana. Then when we were completing the class, no, that time we said we shall complete this portion and then we shall go to the temple. So what is left, I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay. Tudadigana, it is over. Anyway, I'll show you. You can see that.
Yeah, we did that. Vachi Swapi Ajadinam. That all we have done.
Yeah, I think you have finished it.
Yeah, we have done that.
We have done, I think.
Completed. Sandhi completed.
Notes. Yes, no.
In the last class, samprasarana dhatavaha. What are all the dhatus? In fact, I added some more things in that. That is the dhatu, which gana, etc. Those things I added, I sent that notes. Okay. With this, we completed the last class. We did this. The last one is Nummakama. Okay, anyway.
Yeah, up to this, we finished.
Yeah, up to this is both. This is up to this only Tudadiga. After that, it is nothing is there. Anyway, I will quickly explain what I said. Num agama dhatavaha. Okay, Tudadigana. What we said in the last class, with that it is over. I'm just recapping what I said. Tudadigana is over. Okay. Repeat what I said. Muchadigana, Antargana, Tudadigana, we saw. And there are 8 dhatus in this Antargana, which will take Numakama. When it is followed by the Pratyaya Sha. She Muchadina. So therefore you get Numakama. And after that, Numakama, the Nakara, will get the Parasavarna Adesha, that is Sandhi rule we know. Parasavarna. How it gets, not the immediate directly, but the Nakara will become, I have not written here one step I have missed. I think we know it. Apadanta Nakara will become what? Padanta Nakara. Nakara is a Numagama. Which dhatu getting Numagama here? But Apadanta Nakara will get
Anuswara.
Anuswara. Then Muncha plus T. Then Anuswara is here. Parasavana Desha Bhavati. Then Muncha T get. Okay. He just said Parasavana. Doesn't mean it is just directly Parasavana. That Nakara has to be replaced by Anuswara and then Parasavana. Okay. I took it for granted that we understood. Anyway, I will just add one more line. This we have written here very clearly. The next example, Pish plus Tip. Pish Dhatu, which is Muchadigana taking Numakama, then it becomes Anuswara. Then Anuswara is here, Parasavana na Bhavati here, because it is not a Yei letter, therefore Pimshati. So these are the some of the example. So Lupdhatu will become Lumpati. Lupdhatu will become Lumpati. How does it become Lumpati? Maybe I can do that. Lupdhatu, when for, it is one of the Dhatu in the Muchadigana, followed by Sha, it will get Num Agama. Then the Nakara is followed, Apadanta Nakara followed by Jal letter will get Anuswara Desha. Then Parasavarna. So you get Lumpati. So Tadvateva, Anya Dhatavaha, Lumpati, then Vid Dhatu become Bindati, Limpati, Sinchati, Krantati, Kindati, then Pimshati. This is Machadigana is done. Then there is a Vartikam which we saw in the last class. She Trimpadinam Api Upasankhyanam. Trimpadi is another Antargana subgroup which has got about 9 dhatus, where you can see the nakara in the as its upada. Tump, makara is there, that makara is because of nakara. Nakara has come, it has become anuswara, and in parasavarna has happened. That is why tump, you can see the form tump. Similarly, everywhere it is because of that. The last one, trung, here on nakara is there, it will not become Anuswara, because it becomes Anuswara. Sorry, it will become Anuswara, not Parasavarna, because the following letter is not Yai. So therefore, Nakara remains as it is. Nakara remains as it is, means Nakara becomes Anuswara. When you do the Ankarya, Nakara can become Anuswara. It will not become Parasavarna. So these are the nine dhatus, which are in the Trimpadigana. So here, what happens is, this Upada Nakara will be subject to Lopa. Upada Nakara will be subject to Lopa by this rule, which is an important rule. Upada Nakara of Anidit Halanta Dhatu will become Lopa when followed by the Pratyaya, which is Kit or Git Pratyaya. Trim Dhatu belonging to Tudadigana. Therefore, Shap Pratyaya follows. Ganavikrana Pratyaya Shap follows, which is Sarvadhatakam Apit. Therefore, Nit Vat Bhavati, because it is Nit. Therefore, Upada Nakara, this Dhatu is Halanta Dhatu, and Upada Nakara is a Tasilopa Bhavati. Therefore, Trip plus Shap plus T. Upada Nakara becomes Lopaha. Then what happens is, by this Vartikam, it will get Numagama again. So, Trimp plus Sha plus Tip, Padanakara becomes Lopaha by this rule. This is 641, 24, by that rule it will happen. Padanakara is a Lopaha Bhavati, Anidit, Halanta Dhatu, and followed by Nit Pratyaya, Upadanakara becomes Lopaha. Then what happens by this Vartikam? You can name it as Upadanakara Lopa Vidhi, important Vidhi. Let me write this. Vidhi is here, and I will write the sutra. Upada Nakara Lopa Vidhi, important. Aniditam Alaha Upadayaha. This is a rule. Sutram. So here, Upada Nakara Lopa Vidhi is applied first, and then this Vartikam is applied. The Vartikam is above Vartikam, under which only we see this. Shetram Padinam Upasankhyanam, that is Vartikam. Applying that Vartikam, again it gets Numagama. So when Numagama comes, then it becomes Anuswara. Anuswarasya Parasvana Desha Trumpati. So that's what I have written. Step one, Upadanakarasya Lopaha. Then second one, Adinumagama by Vivartikam. Upadanakara Lopaha by Upadanakara Lopavidhi. With this, this Gana is over. So, nothing is there further to elaborate on this. Okay, that's all. And Samprasarana that also I explained, I sent the document, the class we have seen. Samprasarana, this document. Ashtadhyayi class, we have seen Samprasaranam little elaborately. There we have seen other rules pertaining to Subanta, etc. That is not for this class. So that part I have removed, that I have not presented here. Here, whatever we have learned in this class on Samprasaranam, that alone I have put it here. What is Samprasaranam? The ik which replaces n is called Samprasaranam. The substitution as well as the process is called Samprasaranam. And then the second rule is, when Samprasaranam followed by h, when Purva Paryogasthane Samprasaranam Adesha Bhavati, that is Sandhi rule that already we have seen, that is number 2, that we need to remember. Then when Samprasaranam follows a Samprasaranam, then Samprasaranam will not happen. That is number 3. These 3 rules you need to remember with regard to Samprasarana Vidhi. What is Samprasaranam? Number 1. What is Samprasaranam? Ik letter replacing N is called Samprasaranam. The replacement as well as the substitution is called Samprasaranam. Then, when Samprasaranam followed by Ach, then Purva Deshaha Bhavati, both the succeeding and preceding will be replaced by Samprasaranam. Number 3, when Samprasaranam is followed by, when Samprasaranam follows, when a Samprasaranam follows what? Follows the N letter, follows N, then Samprasaranam will not happen for N. That is number 3. These are the 3 rules we need to remember with regard to Samprasaranam. Then the 2 sutrams which I listed in the last class, Vachisupi Ajadi Namkiti and Grahi Jya Vayi Vyadi Vashti Vichati Vrishchati Prachati Vajati Namkiti. This 2, you can see the dhatus. There are many dhatus in these 2 rules. The 2 rules presents many dhatus. The first one presents about 11 dhatus and second one around 9 dhatus. So this dhatu, the first one, vach dhatu, swap dhatu, then yajadi, which is antargana of dhvadigana dhatu, when followed by kit pratyaya, will undergo samprasaranam. Then the second one, the 9 dhatus are listed here, among which the last 4, which are highlighted in yellow color, these are tudadigana dhatu. This will undergo samprasaranam even when followed by nit. Niticha, not even, niticha means Nit also follows. It means Chakarat, Kit also. When Kit Pratyaya or Nit Pratyaya follows, these Dhatus, Grahi, Jya, Vayi, Vyadi, Vashti, Michati, Vrishchati, Prichati, Brajati, Braj, Prasjatu, will undergo Samprasaranam. For the second one, that is, these 9 Dhatus, when followed with kit pratyaya or nit pratyaya, samprasaranam will happen. Whereas for the first one, only when followed by kit pratyaya, samprasaranam will happen. That is the difference between the 2. Please note, that is why kiti is here and niticha is here. In chakarat, you can bring in kiti also. So that is what I have listed here. Vach, swap and dhatus belonging to antargana, Yajadi Akhvadigana will undergo Samprasaranam when followed by Kit Pratyaya. And the Dhatus, Grah, Jya, Vench, Vyad, Vash, Vech, Vrash, Prach and Brash will get Samprasaranam when followed by Kit or Nit Pratyaya. Nit Pratyaya is not there for the first one, Vach, Swaps and Yajadigana. When Nit Pratyaya follows, Samprasaranam will not happen. So, among this, Among this, the first one contains dhatus belonging to Vadigana and Adadigana. So that we are not interested. Already we have covered in that section. Vadigana dhatu, we have seen in Vadi section. In that context, we have seen already this. So that is not required. I have done here samprasaranam, which you can, we have seen in the last class. Then we are interested only in the second part, where the first five dhatus belonging to Vivadigana, Kriyadigana, Divadigana, that also not required. We are interested only in Tudadigana dhatu. In Tudadigana dhatu, will undergo samprasaranam. I think this is what you are asking. Samprasaranam, here we have not derived. Yes? Is it what you are asking?
No, Shanajai, I was wrong actually. I finished. I was looking at the previous class notes.
Okay.
So, yeah, very sorry.
It's okay. So, anyway, since we have started, let me do one dhatu for this. This Tudadigana, four dhatus which are listed here. I'll take one dhatu and do the derivation. You can take prach dhatu. Prach dhatu plus sha plus tip. Here, prach dhatu followed by the pratyaya sha, the ngit pratyaya. Therefore, what will happen? Samprasanam happens. Samprasanam happens for the N letter, which is repaya. So, pra will become, first let me write, to identify the so. Repa will become R. Then R is samprasanam, samprasanam followed by H. Therefore, Pura Paryogasthane samprasanam adesha bhavati. Therefore, R will be there. So, Pakara plus R will become Pr. Pr. In prachati will become prachati. You get the form prachati. So this is done. Similarly, brasch dhatu, one more dhatu, we can take brasch pake to dadigana. Brasj plus sha plus tip. Here, N letter is repa, followed by nit pratyaya. Therefore, samprasaranam will happen. Repa will be replaced by r. Therefore, you get brasj. Then, after that, sakara will be replaced by what letter? Talabhya Shakara. What sandhi is there? Chitra sandhi will happen.
Chitra sandhi.
So, brash jati, then jal letter followed by jash. Jal will be replaced by jash letter. So, brijjati iti rupam. So, you get the form brijjati. Okay. So you get the form Brijati. So with this is done. Over. Over Rashtu becomes, what will happen here? Brischati. Repa is there, will be replaced by R. Samprasanam happens, you get Brischati. Similarly, here, what will happen here? This is an example. Okay, which also we can do just to show you when Samprasanam follows. N will not undergo samprasanam. For that, only that example. Vyach dhatu. I will take the example. Vyach plus sha plus t. Here, vakara is a N letter. Yakara also N letter. Then, ach follows. Ach means ach the letter. Akara, chakara. Sha plus tip. Nit pratyaya follows. Therefore, yakara will undergo samprasanam. Yakara will be replaced by what letter? Ikara.
Ikara.
So, E is samprasanam. Samprasanam is followed by ach letter. Therefore, what will happen? Purva parivastane kim adesha bhavati. E.
Purva.
Purva. So, now, what will happen to Vakara? Is it not a N letter? Will it not undergo samprasanam? No.
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 Because E is samprasanam. When samprasanam follows, samprasanam will not happen for the N. Therefore, you get the form V with Ichati. That's it. This is the form. So, with this, it is done. Okay, Tadadigana is over. That's why I sent this document. Finished. So, with this, over. Okay. So, already these things you know. So, it's not something new. Now, shall we move to the Churadigana?
Yes.
Yes. Samprasanam, this document which I sent is the second document. The first one contains some Subanta also, which I have taught you in the Ashtadhyayi class. But here we have not seen. That is why just to mention what Samprasanam is and the rules related to that, whatever we have seen. Okay, so now we will continue Churadigana. It's not that it is first time you are seeing Churadigana also. We have seen. Now we are going to see in detail what are all the dhatus. All the dhatus. So we are not missing any dhatus. All the dhatus we are covering. This is elaborately. So whatever the gana we have seen so far, Bhavadigana, then Divadigana, and then Tudadigana, all the dhatus we have covered. All the dhatus and the rules related to deriving the form. Everything we have covered. Everything we have covered. Now Churadigana. Churadigana we will see. Churadigana, 10th gana. So Churadigana dhatu will take the pratyaya nich. Churadigana dhatu will take the pratyaya nich. Churadigana dhatus will take nich pratyaya. You see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nich for Churadigana is Swarte. Please note. Nich for Churadigana is Swarte. Swarte means in its own meaning. Swarte. Swasyarte. That is to tell that it is not in the sense of preranarte, not causative. Nich can be added to dhatus belonging to other gana also. In that case, it becomes preranarte. Whereas naturally, the dhatus belonging to Churadigana will take nich dhatu, that is swarte. So, how do you know this Churadigana dhatus take nich pratyaya? That is by the sutram. I'm writing here the sutram. This is a satyapa pasharupa vina tula shloka sena loma tvacha varma varna churna. Up to that it is not required for us. The last one is required. Churadibhyaha. Churadibhyo, churadibhyo, nich. This is what is, we are interested in this. Churadibhyo, nich. Churadibhyaha, nich bhavati. So, churadigana dhatu, taking nich pratyaya, this is by this rule, 3125. So now, regarding niche, we need to know certain things. Already we know. What is niche? What is niche?
Ardhadhatukam.
Sarvadhatukam or Ardhadhatukam?
Ardhadhatukam.
It is Ardhadhatukam Pratyaya. And Nakara is? It letter. Therefore, what will happen?
Vritti will happen.
Therefore, Vritti will happen. Vritti will happen where?
To the
last.
For the last eight letters, Iganta.
Iganta will take Vritti, right?
Yeah.
And what else? What else will happen?
And the penalty.
Asva. Asva will take Vritti. Okay, then.
Asvaikupada
also will take guna. So, nich being an adhadhatuka pratyaya, therefore, I just copy paste from another file. Nich being an adhadhatuka pratyaya, therefore, ikanta will take vriddhi, and rasvaikupada will take guna. And rasva at upada, that is akara, will take vriddhi. Nich being adhadhatukam, these are the three possible angakarya. These are the three possible angakarya can happen. Right. The three possible angakarya. Which can happen because of niche. Oh. Now, when you add niche to Churadigana Dhatu, what do you get?
Chori.
Churadigana Dhatu. We get a new Dhatu.
Yoda. Okay.
Okay. You get this adding niche, you get Nijantam. Right? You get Nijantam. And Nijantam is Nijantam is a dhatu. Adding nich, you get Nijantam. Nijantam is nich antam Nijantam. Nich antam yasya saha Nijanta. Nijantaha dhatu. Nijantaha will become, is called a dhatu. So nich is a dhatu. Nijantam is a dhatu. How you get the sanya dhatu? Vedi sutra. Sanadhyantaha dhataha. That one sutra is there. Sanadhyantaha dhataha. That's the rule. Sutram is there. It says dhatus ending with sanadi pratyaya. San adi. In that adi, nich also is included. Adi means etc. So adding nich, you get Nijantam. Nijantam becomes a dhatu by this rule. Sanadantaha dhataha. So, Nijantam becomes a dhatu. It's a new dhatu now. It's a new dhatu. Which gana it belongs now?
Bhadigana.
It is treated as though it belongs to Bhadigana. Therefore, being a new dhatu, being a derived dhatu or new dhatu. You can call derived or new dhatu, whatever. Being a derived new dhatu, by default, it is treated like vibhavadigana dhatu, which means that it will take shab when shab will take when sarvadhatuka pratyaya follows. Sarvadhatuka pratyaya follows in kartari. In kartari only sarvadhatuka pratyaya comes in karmani, yak comes in kartari. So these steps you need to remember. Adding nich, you get nijanta. Nijanta is a new dhatu. Being a new dhatu, now then it is treated like a bhavadigana dhatu. Therefore, it will take shap. Then all the shap being a gana vikrana, the angakarya, whatever is supposed to happen, it will happen now. What are the angakaryas which can happen? Because of shap. Shap is sarvadhatuka pratyaya. Now, nich is ardhadhatuka. Shap is sarvadhatuka. For that, what are the angakarya? Shab being a sarvadhatuka, what are the angakaryas possible? Possible angakaryas are
Karta will take guna.
Even just copy pasting this. Iganta will take guna. That is 7384. Sarvadhatuka Ardhadhatuka Yoga. Iganta will take guna. Then Rasva Ikupada will take
guna.
That is by the same rule.
Take guna, yeah.
Six. Then what else happen?
That's then all. Pukanta will take guna.
Pukanta Lagupadasya. It is there, so number two. These are only two. Atupada, nothing happens.
Yeah, nothing happens.
So putting together only the five angakaryas always we say. Putting this together. So these are the possible angakarya, right? Then. Now being a new dhatu, will it be treated to be a parasmepadi or atmanepadi? By default, it is considered to be ubhayapadi, by default. But there are exceptions. By default, these dhatus are considered to be ubhayapadi. Please note. And there are rules where it can be assigned a parasmepadi or atmanepadi, that we will see. Now let us take one by one dhatu and derive the form. Churadigana is simple, except for some dhatus. For that we need to know certain rules. So now let us take the dhatu I'm taking some dhatus, then I will see why I'm taking those dhatus. Because there is a rule because of which I take those dhatus. That is pukkagama related dhatus, we will take. That is akaranta dhatu, we will take. Let us take, do like that. So first is ajanta dhatavaha. Okay. The broad classification is ajanta, halanta, dhatus ending with ach, dhatu ending with hal. So let us take ajanta dhatu. Among the ajanta dhatu, akara adanta dhatu, that is akara anta dhatu is that we will see later. First we will take akara anta dhatu. Akara anta dhatavaha. Under ajanta, we will do akaranta dhatus. Dhatu ending with dirga akara. So, what are they? We'll see. When akaranta dhatus, what will happen to akaranta dhatus when it takes, when nich pratyaya follows? Akaranta dhatus, what will happen to akaranta dhatus?
Pukagama
will come. We'll take pukagama. This we have seen elaborately in Nijanta section. Nijanta already we have seen. There's a separate playlist there, I think. We have seen Nijanta elaborately. Mitam, Rasvaha and all. We have seen. Remember, that Rasvatam happens. Rasvatam happens for the mit. What is mit? Some dhatus are assigned the sanya mit. Remember that, those things?
Yeah, ghatadeva.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Ghatadeva, mitaha, mitam, rasvaha. We have seen all those things. Anyway, I'll just quickly cover. We can see that. Oh, akaranta dhatus will take pukkagama. When? When? When does it happen? When nich follows? When nich follows? When nich follows, akaranta dhatu will take pukkagama. Now let us take akarantam akaranta dhatus. Let us take the dhatu, nya dhatu. Nya dhatu belongs to this gana, churadi gana. Nya dhatu meaning avabodhane, I think. Let me check that. Nya dhatu, churadi gana dhatu. Niyoge, okay, it is in this gana, it means niyoge, to order. Niyoge, it is nyadhatu, it is avabodhana in the kriyadi gana, ninth gana, okay. And marana toshana nishamaneshu, to kill, to hurt, that is in the bodhi gana. In this gana, nyadhatu means to order. Nya, to order or to remind, that meaning, so nyadha is. Niyoge dhatu meaning. So nya dhatu plus nich. When nich when follows, dhatu will take pukkagama. So nya plus nich. After that, what will happen? Nya plus nich.
Then nya plus e.
Yeah, plus E.
Yeah,
E is the content.
E
for then C, pukkagama is there.
Mm-hmm.
And what is the letter preceding to pukkagama? Pakara. It is A is there. It is not ik letter. Therefore, guna doesn't happen. If it is ik letter,
yeah, guna will
happen. Guna is ik letter, guna. That is what is given in this rule. Rasva ik upada will take guna. Rasva ik upada will take guna. Puganta lagu padasya cha. Puganta lagu padasya cha. Puk anta lagu pada. Anyway, that we will see that example when it comes become clear. So here nothing happens. Therefore, you will get nyapi. Now nyapi is in nijanta. Nijantam, it is a new dhatu. It is treated like the vadigana dhatu. So nyapi will become. So nyapi is a new dhatu. Now we can add shapratyaya. Nyapi plus tip will become nyapi plus Asha plus Tet. Sanyapi, it is Iganta now. Iganta Dhatu followed by a Sarvadhatuka Pratyaya, Pit Pratyaya. Therefore, Nyapi will become Nyape Guna Bhavati. Nyape plus A plus T. A plus A Ayadi Sandhi. Therefore, you get Nyap, Nyapaya, Nyapayati. Nyapayati, Nyapayataha, Nyapayanti. I'm just doing Lat Lakara by default. You can do any Lakara. Ling Lakara would be. What is the form in Ling Lakara?
Nyapayet.
Nyapayetam.
Nyapayehi.
Nyapayetam. Nyapayeta. Nyapayeyam. Nyapayeva. Nyapayema. Lot Lakara. Nyapayetu.
Napayantu.
Napaya. Napayatam. Napayatam. Then.
Napayani.
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 Napayama. So here, and the list has said Akaranda Dhatus. Not only Akaranda Dhatus, other Dhatus are also can be included here. So, in addition to Akaranta Dhatus, some more dhatus also can take Phuk Agama. What are those dhatus? Number one. Number one, Hridhatu. Hridhatu, Gati Prapana Yogo. Gati Prapana Yogo. Hridhatu, which is in the Churadigana. Gati Prapana Yogo. Gati Prapana Yogo means movement. Gati Prapana Yogo. In Charadigana. 1 minute, let me check. It is not in the Dhatu Pata, but it is given. Ru also can be taken. Just a minute, let me check. It is in Dhatu Pata. Yeah, it is. Dhatu Pata, it is not the right thing, but it is Ru is one more Dhatu is there, which is in the Churadigana. You can take it as Churadigana Ru Dhatu. The Rupam is Gati Prapana Yogo, Gati movement, Prapana to reach. It's also belonging to Churadigana only. So you can take Gati Prapana Yogo, Churadigana Dhatu. So what will happen to Hri Dhatu? Just a minute, let me confirm one which Gana it belongs. Then Hri Dhatu, not the Churadigana. Sorry, it is not a Churadigana. It is Dvadigana only. Rudhatu belongs to Bhuvadigana only. Maybe in Bhuvadigana we would have seen the Dhatu Hru. Rudhatu in Bhuvadigana under causative form. So Rukaranta Dhatu Gati Prapana Yogo. It is Bhuvadigana Dhatu. Here it is out of context, but still we can cover because it takes Pukakama. Pukakama is a common thing. Therefore, we can do this Dhatu, Hru Dhatu. refer Bhuvadigana. In Bhuvadi section, we would have covered. Please check your notes.
Yeah, we have written as R. Yeah. Dukara plus Shap will come. R only. That's all we have written.
R.
Yeah. Gru will become Gar. That's all we have written.
Gru will become?
Gru will become Gar. That is, we have written. Rukara
is, that is sixth gana. Hru dhatu. Hru. You see the screen?
Yeah, I'm seeing it.
Prapana yogo. Hru dhatu. Dvadigana dhatu.
Yeah, that's what I'm
saying. You're saying Gru, right?
No. For that, the example has given us Gru. For Rukaranta Dhatoha, we have written the Bhuvadigana.
Yes.
Just Rukaranta Dhatoha, we have example Gru. Yeah.
Bhuvadigana, what I mean is, Bhuvadigana Dhatu context we would have seen means,
Bhuvadigana we didn't see this Dhatuji, that's what I'm saying. We didn't see this one. No,
no. What I mean is, in Bhuvadigana Dhatu, Ru Dhatu, in this context, it is niche. Therefore, where you will see?
Under the,
Under
the
Arpayati. Arpayati you will give
it. Yeah, under what section you will see?
Okay.
Nijanta, not in this Bhuvadigana.
Yeah.
Bhuvadigana you will not find.
Mm-hmm.
Bhuvadigana, these dhatus you will not find. This you will find in Nijanta of Bhuvadigana.
Okay.
Right? Nijanta, what we have seen, there you see. There you see this dhatu would be there.
So, it's there. You have given it as Arpayati.
Arpayati.
Yeah. Yes.
So therefore, Ru plus Nich. Ru dhatu belong to Bhuvadigana Gati Prapana Yoga. When it takes Nich, then what will happen? So, Ru plus Nich. So in Nijanta, you would have seen this. Causative form of Bhuvadigana Dhatu, Hru Dhatu. So please see here in the Nijanta file. It may be there. We would have covered in Puganta section separately. If then we will do it now here. So Hru plus Nich. What will happen? Hru will get Pukkagama. Then Nich follows Ru Dhatu, which means Gati Prapana Yoga, belonging to Bhuvadigana, will take Puk Agama, Rup plus Nich. Now, Puganta and Lagu Upada, therefore what will happen? Puganta is Puk Agama. Agama being Antaranga Karya, so Agama should be done. Don't do the Vriddhi Karya first and then add Puk Agama. If you add Vriddhikarya, it will become R. After that, if you add Pukkagama, it will become R. That is, you will not get Ishtarupam. And also, Pukkagama, Agama being Antaranga. Therefore, Pukkagama should be added first. When you add, Ru will become Upada. When it becomes Upada, it can take Guna only, not Vriddhi. Therefore, Ru will become Arp. Arp plus E. So what you get is Arpi. So Arpi is a new dhatu. So when you do the lakara, let lakara by default, if you take, you get the form Arpayati. This you see in Nijanta file, Nijanta section. So there we would have seen this. Arpi will become Arpe, Arpe plus A plus T will become Arpayati. Arpayati, Arpayataha, Arpayanti. Can you check Nijanta? Nijanta also, the document which I sent, there under Pukkagama section, some dhatus I would have listed. One dhatu is this Hru dhatu. There we would have seen. I can show you Nijanta. Yes.
Shamayi, Akaranta Dhatu.
Akaranta, yes. All those dhatus. Please refer Nijanta. You have to connect the document. this I'm showing you that Nijanta document, what I sent there. There, this Pukkagama related rules. Pukkagama. Atvam when knee follows. Kri, di, ji. Okay. Yeah, this is the one. Hru, hri, vli, hri, knoyi, kshmayi. And akara and the dhatus. We'll take Pukkagama when knee follows. Do you see the screen? This is the Nijanta document. Among this, since we are seeing Churadigana, there we dealt with Akaranta Dhatu. Example, Nya Dhatu, what we saw. And these Dhatus belong into other Gana. These Dhatus belong into other Gana. When Nich follows means what? It is Nijanta Rupam. Dhatu belonging to, Ru Dhatu belonging to Bhadigana. Similarly, other Dhatus, whichever Gana it belongs. When it will take Nich? Only when Nijanta, when you derive Nijanta Rupam. So, in that case, what will happen? Like these, Akaranda Dhatu, what we saw for Gnya Dhatu, Churadigana, taking Pukkagama. Similarly, these Dhatus also will take Pukkagama. Therefore, Ru plus Nich, Rup, then Angakarya happens, or Appayati. Similarly, Hri, Hri Dhatu will take Pukkagama. It will become Hreep. So, Hri will become Hreep. After that, Hri is a Dirga. It is Upada Dirga. Therefore, Angakarya na Bhavati. Hri Dhatu, which Gana is it? Juhotyadi Gana. So, let me do that. Hri Dhatu, it is Juhotyadi Gana. So, here, in this document, what I am typing that, these are additional information about this is not Churadigana Dhatu, other Gana Dhatu, other Gana Dhatus, which also will take Pukkagama. So, it is a context is Pukkagama. There in that, we are saying Dhatus belonging to the other Gana, Hri, which is Jugotyadi Gana. He is Lajjayam. Jugotyadi Gana Dhatu, that is third Gana, which we will see. Nijanta Rupam we are deriving. So, Hri plus Nich. Hri plus Nich. What will happen? Pukkagama it will take. If you have to add Pukkagama and then do. Without Pukkagama, Hri can become Vriddhi. Once you add Pukkagama, Hri being a Dirga, now it becomes Dirga Upada. Therefore, Angakarya will not happen. So, Hri plus Nich will become Hreepi. Hreepi is a new Dhatu. Being a new Dhatu, you can derive the, you can add the Pratyaya and derive Lakara. Laktakara if you derive Hreepi plus Shap plus Tip. So what you will get? What you will get? Hreepi will become Hreepi plus Shap plus Tip. Can it get Angakarya now? Can it undergo Angakarya? Yes or no?
Yes, no. Hreepi is
there. Huh?
Hreepi plus Shap, so it will become.
Hmm.
Ikara is the ending, so it can become Ikara.
Sorry, I did a mistake. Here, Hreep plus Nich, here. Not Hreepi, yeah? Hreep here. Hreep plus Nich. What is this? Puganta. Puganta.
Yeah. Lagu upada.
Puganta also. This is Pukanta. Even if it is a Pukanta, Hri will take?
Gunavri.
Guna. Hri. Yeah.
Okay.
Hri.
Hri. Before adding Pukkagama, if you do, it can undergo Vriddhikarya. Now, adding Pukkagama, because Puk being Antaranga, you have to add Agama and then only do the Angakarya. Now, once you add Pukkagama, Hri becomes Upada. Being Upada, now, will it undergo Angakarya? It will not undergo Angakarya, but because the mentioning of the word Puganta Yeah, two things are there. Here you have to note. Puganta lagu upadasya. Lagu upada will take guna and pukanta also will take guna. Pukanta means puk is the anta and the preceding letter, ik letter could be a hraswa or dirga. It could be a hraswa or dirga. That's what pukanta means. Puganta. So puganta meaning which will that puk agama which has come to the dhatu, the ajanta dhatu, among that iganta dhatu, that ik letter could be a rasva or dirga. Ik letter could be a rasva or dirga. So this part, let me write it so that puk antam. Pugantam, which means that the dhatus, it will be read iganta dhatus, that because we are talking about the yangakara, iganta dhatus. Iganta dhatu is could be rasva or dirga. Raswa or Dirga. Iganta dhatus taking or having puk agama. Will also take guna. So here in this Puganta Lagu Upadasya, Raswa Ik Upada will take Guna. Then, okay, yes, star mark, I think I will write it as number 3. So that, number 3, Puk Antam Pugantam, that is Igantad, this part I will hold. Igantadatus, that is Raswa Dirga, having pukkagama will also take guna, having pukkagama. So in this case, the rasva upada, that is ikupada, the ikupada, the upada ik letter can be a rasva or dirga. So iganta dhatus, rasva dirga having pukkagama, which means once you take pukkagama, that it is no more iganta, it becomes upada. So ik upada da, it becomes ik upada. Becomes ik upada. Ik upada is there, it can be a rasva or dirga, because already we have the orientation that rasva only will take guna, but dirga also, because pukkagama is, which means rasva or dirga ik upada will also take guna. Iganta dhatus having pukkagama, or one minute, I will modify this. Iganta dhatus having pukkagama, dhatus having pukkagama, which means ik, I do rewrite this. Give me a minute. Is it proper to say iganta dhatu? Just a minute, let me think. Iganta dhatu rasva dirga having pukkagama, which means ikupada will take guna. Yeah, it's okay. I am writing here iganta dhatu because ik only will take gunadi angakarya. So therefore iganta dhatu. So iganta dhatus, which could be rasva dirga, having pukkagama, which means ik upada rasva dirga, will also take guna. So this is number 3. This is what this part of this rule says. Puk anta. Lagu upada we know. Puk anta also. So when it is Puganta, now Hri plus Nich, this will take Pukagama. Therefore, this is a Puganta and the Upada is Ik letter. Dhatu is Iganta Dhatu. Being Iganta Dhatu, therefore it can take Anga, it can take guna, it can undergo angakarya. And puk agama being antaranga, when puk is ordained, now this is no more iganta, it becomes ik upada. Now if the ik upada, generally what our understanding is, if it is raswa only, it will take guna. Being puganta dhatu, therefore there it doesn't matter whether raswa or dirga, whatever it may be, it will can take angakarya, which is guna here, therefore he will become hre. Hrepi. So it is not hrepi, it is hrepi. So hrepi plus dip. Hrepi plus dip. Now it will become hrepe. You can do the angakarya. Hrepi is a new dhatu. Being nijanta, you can add the tip pratyaya. Then ganavikrana. Then the ganavikrana shap comes by default. Then Hrepi plus Shap will become Hrepe. Angakarya happens. Then you can do Ayadi Sandhi. Hrepe will become Hrepaya, Hrepayati. So Hrepayati is a Rupam. Okay. So this is Puganta. You understand this? Puganta?
Yes, yeah.
Already we have seen this Puganta. This is an Puk Anta. Please note that. Pukagama, that which comes for certain dhatus and the akaranda dhatus of the churadigana. Now, hridhatu bhuvadigana and hridhatu jugotyadigana. There are some more dhatus that also will take pukagama, the third dhatu. The third dhatu is vli dhatu. Vli, which is Varane, ninth gana. Vli, Varane, Krayadigana. Nijanta rupam of this dhatu. Vli, Varane, to choose. Varane is to choose. Vli plus Nich. The Nich follows. Vli dhatu will take Pukkagama. Therefore, it will become Vli. Now, this is a Puganta. Being Puganta, the Upada, not Rasva, the Upada ikleta can take Guna, therefore it become Vle, Vlepi. So, Vli, then Vlep, Vlepi. Now, Vlepi is a new Dhatu. Vlepi will become Vlepe, Vlepayati. Form is Vlepayati. Causative form of Vli Dhatu is Vlepayati. The next Dhatu, Ri Dhatu. Ri Dhatu, there are two Dhatus. One is Ring Dhatu, Divadigana, Ri Dhatu, Gati Reshane Yoko, Krayadigana, ninth gana. Both dhatus we can take. The next one, number four. I take Ri dhatu gati reshana yoho. Ninth gana dhatu, which means to gati, gatyartha, to go. Reshana yoga means to kill, to destroy, that meaning. So, hri plus nich. Iganta dhatu, belonging to kriyadigana, when nich pratyaya follows, takes pukagama, therefore hri plus nich. Now, this is a puganta. Being puganta, the ik upada will take guna, therefore rapi, become rapi is a new dhatu, So repi will become repayati. Repe, repayati, repayataha, repayanti iti rupam. So ri dhatu form is repayati. One more dhatu is there. Ring dhatu also can be considered. Ring dhatu also have the same form. Ring sravane, it is divadigana. Divadigana dhatu, it form, its form also, nijantarupam also will be repayati. Note this. Then the next dhatu is knu, knu dhatu. Dhatu is, which is bhavadigana dhatu. This is number. This dhatu, ring dhatu, you can take it as number five, number five, fifth one, and number six, noi dhatu. Yes, dhatu is noi dhatu, which belongs to bhavadigana, which means shabde. Shabde. Unda nature, to sound and to be wet, Vadigana dhatu. So, knui, dhatu is knui dhatu, kakara, nak, then nakara, kakara, and u, then yakara. Upadeshika dhatu is knui, content is knui. So, knui. Plus nich, what will happen to knui now? It will take pukkagama. Pukkagama being antaranga, do that first. So becomes knui. Now what will happen? What will happen to yakara? What will happen to yakara? We have seen before, yakara, kimbhavati, yakarasya, lopaha bhavati, by what rule? We have seen in the...
Yeah, well, in
this under lakara, this the... Lakara derivation, we have seen this rule. Ikara vakara when followed by Valadi. Yes, somebody said Valadi. That's right. Valadi. When followed by Val letter. When followed by Val. We have seen this in Sarvadhatuka Lakara declension.
First one, yeah.
Lopaha Vyorvali. Where we saw this, I think in ling lakara, in ling lakara it comes there, that siya adesha comes, remember, in ling lakara siyut,
yeah,
right, that yakara is there, that siya, that yakara, there we have seen this yakara becomes lopaha. When does it happen? When followed by ival, valadi, pratyaya, etc. we saw. So if you can remember, please see that in Sarvadhatuka, the pratyaya derivation, we have seen for adanta and anadanta gana. So there adanta or anadanta anga. So the derivation of the pratyas of for Sarvadhatuka and Adhudhatuka, not Adhudhatuka, Sarvadhatuka, that Linglakara, we have seen this siya and yeah, siya. Let me see. We saw the siya. Please see that I am not able to open the document. Where is it? I have to find out. So yakara becomes lopaha when followed by val. That is a rule. So therefore, applying that rule, Yakara is here followed by Pakara. Pakara is a vowel letter. Therefore, Pakara, Yakara say Lopaka Bhavati, therefore, no. So, within bracket I write Lopaha Vyorvali, that is a sutra. So, Yakara Vakara, Yakara or Vakara will become Lopa when followed by Val. Okay. Lopaha Vyorvali. This Yakara Bakara Lopa we have seen in Sandhi context also. There it is different. You remember which Sandhi context? There also. Two places this Bakara Yakara Lopa happens. There Lopaha Shakalyasya. That is Av R Av I R I. Right?
Yeah.
There, this Yakara and Vakara, that Vanta, Vanta and Nyanta, when followed by what? When followed by Ash, remember the Sandhi rule. When followed by Ash, what will happen? It's not only Av, it can be anything. I'm just saying, giving the example of Ayadi Sandhi, that's all. This ending with Vakara or Yakara preceded by Apurva. That is why I gave the example. Apurvasya. That is Av, I, followed by Ash letter. Among the Ash letter, we can split this Ash as Ach plus Hash. When Ach follows, what will happen to this Padanta Yakara or Vakara? It will become Lopaha, right?
Yeah, in
Visarga
Sandhi also.
That's what it is. Visarga Sandhi also. Visarga Sandhi also, that Yakara is ordained, that Yakara when preceded by A. Okay, but also you can take preceded by A, Apurva. Yakara se kem bhavati, Lopaha bhavati. Nityam Lopaha bhavati when followed by Ach. And when followed by Hash, it is. Sorry, when followed by Hash, it is Nityam Lopaha. When followed by Hash, it is functional.
Yeah.
Right? So, this is another place where we saw this Yakara Vakara. Lopaha Shakalyasya. That Yakara Lopaha is Apurva, that Yakara Vakara. That Lopa is optional when followed by Hash. It is a must when followed by Hash. This is different. Here it is, well follow, well letter follows. When well letter follows, this Yakara Vakara, it is not, need not be a Padanta Yakara. It is a Padanta Yakara Vakara. There in the Sandhi context, it is Padanta Yakara Vakara. Please note, right? That's the difference. Here it is, a Padanta Yakara Vakara. If it is Padanta Yakara Vakara, then that also Lopaha Shakalyasya, that is in Tripadi section. Whereas this is in
Svara
Saptadhyayi. Okay. Therefore, this Yakara Vakara, it is not Padanta. It is Apadanta Vakara Yakara followed by Val letter. Val is not, need not be a Pratyaya, just a Val letter. Not Valadi Pratyaya. It is just a Val. When Val Pratyaya, that Val, in the Val Pratyahara, whatever the letters are there, when those letter, any of the letter follow the Yakara Vakara, then Yakara Vakara will become Lopa. Okay. This is incidental. Remember to trying to connect with Lopa Shakalyasya. There also Yakara Vakara.
In Nijanta notes also you have given like that. Yeah, Yakara and Vakara and followed by Y becomes Lopa.
Become Lopa. I have given that rule.
Yeah, not a rule, but you just mentioned that.
Lopo Vyorvali, that is the rule. This is in 6166. You can note if that sutram is. Okay, I will write the 6166 to show that is a, this is in Sapada Saptadhyayi, not in Tripadi. You may think
Linked derivation. Hmm? Linked derivation also we have done that.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to think. Yeah, linked derivation we have seen.
Yeah, many times. Yeah.
That is why I still refer to that. Yes. Yasut, yeah, not in Yasut also. Yakara becomes Lopa. Yasut, Siyut. Yes. Yasut is Ya is the beginning. That is a, but okay, that doesn't happen because Ya, it is followed by A, Yas. But Siyut is happened.
Siyut, it happens. Yeah.
Siyut, it happens. This is 6166, that the rule. So therefore, what happens here now, you get Knoop. Knoop plus Nich will become. And this is a Puganta, being Puganta. Therefore, Upada is ik letter. Need not be Rasva. Please note that. That is where generally we commit mistake. Because we have strong orientation, Upada must be a Rasva for Guna to happen. But here, Ukara is, which is Upada, but the last letter is Pakara, which is Agama letter, Puk Agama. Therefore, Puk Anta, we say. Please note, this Pakara must be a an Agama. Then only it will apply. If a Dhatu naturally has Pakara, then it will not apply. Okay, if it is a Puganta Dhatu, then the Upada Ikalatar need not be Rasva. It can be Rasva or Dirga. Then it will take, undergo Angakarya, Guna Angakarya happen. Therefore, what will happen? So, Pakara, then No will become No. Nope. No plus E will become, form would become Knopi. So Knopi is a new Dhatu. So therefore form would be Knopi, first step becomes Knopi, Knopayati, Knopayataha, Knopayanti. Knopi plus Shap plus step, Knopi will become Knope. Knope plus A, Nopayati iti rupam. So, Nui becomes Nopayati. Nijanta rupam of Nui Dhatu, which is in Vadigana, will be Nopayati, taking Puk Agama. Then the next one, next Dhatu, I think this is the last Dhatu. So, 4, 5, 6, then 7th Dhatu. All these Dhatus are not Churadi, other than Churadi. Dhatu other than Churadi Gana also taking Puk Agama. So next one is Kshmai Dhatu. This also Kshmai. Dirga Ikaradhar. E is Anubandha. Content is Kshmai only. The Dhatu belongs to Vadigana Vidhunane. Vidhunane means to tremble. Kshmayi Vidhunane. Vadigana Dhatu. Kshmayi plus Nich. Here it is not Iganda, therefore, you can see Ma is there. It is Dirga, therefore, Vangakare will happen. But it will take Pukkakama. Kshmayi plus Takara. Then Yakara Silopa Bhavati followed by one letter. Therefore, it will become Kshmai plus E becomes Kshmai. So, Kshmai is a new Dhatu. Kshmapi. Yakara Silopa Bhavati. Then Kshmai is there. Kshmap plus E. Kshmapi. So, Kshmapi is a new Dhatu. Then add Tipratya, Kshmapi plus Shap plus Tip. Kshmapi will become Kshmape. Then Kshmapa Yati Iti Rupam. So these Dhatus, the 7 Dhatus which do not belong to Churadigana, also take Pukkagama. So that is what I have written here. In addition to Akara Dhatus, Samvara Dhatus belonging to other Gana other ganas also can take pukkahama. So this is to cover pukkahama. This is to cover pukkahama, and akaranta is also covers other gana also. Akaranta. In the tenth gana, churadi gana, we have akaranta dhatu. Therefore, we gave this example. Nyap taking pukkahama becomes nyapayati. Okay. So the dhatus what we listed here, these dhatus belong into other gana. So these dhatus will take pukkahama. So what is the sutram for this? Arti Hri. I'll give the sutram. Arti Hri Vli Hri Knui Kshmai Atam Puknau. That's a rule. Arti stands for Hridatu. Arti is Hridatu. Hridatu becomes Arti. Then Hridatu. How it becomes Arti? That Dhatu Nirdesha. Yes, seen that. Don't worry about Hri is Arti. Then Hridatu. Then Vli Dhatu. Then Hridatu. Knui Dhatu. Then Kshmai Dhatu. Then Atam. Atam is Akaranta Dhatu. Puk. Now. Now is when Ni follows. Our context is Nich. So which Nich follows, Puk Agama Bhavati. Here Pung is there, that is Sandhi. Because a Sandhi becomes Pung. It is Puk. Now. It is Puk. And now Kakara is replaced by the Parasavarna. What is the rule? Kakara replaced by Parasavarna. What is that niyama? What is the niyama? Anybody? It is Puk plus now. How it become Pung now?
Jastva.
Jastva. How can be Jastva?
Puk. Okay. Kakara become
Nakara.
Okay. Kakara. Nakara, anunasika.
What is the rule? Tell me, anybody. Puk plus now. Anuswara follows, right? Your letter followed by anunasika, what will happen? Your letter followed by anunasika. Kakara, is it a your letter or not?
Okay. Yaraha anunasika.
Your letter followed by anunasika. Your letter will can be replaced by its anunasika optionally. Therefore, pung now. So pung now it is nakara is there. That is because of sandhi. It is puk now. Now means when ni follows. Ni is nijanta. Nich okay. Or nin or anything.
Okay.
Ni follows. Pukkagama will happen for which dhatus? Those dhatus are listed here. Harti, which is Hridatu. Hri dhatu. Vli dhatu. Hri dhatu. Knuyi. Kshmayi. Then Atam. Atam stands for Akaranda dhatus. This is the rule, sutram, which ordains Pukkagama for the dhatus. Here, all the dhatus up to Kshmayi belong to specific gana, different ganas we have seen here, Duadi, Krayadi, etc. Atam is there, Atam is Akaranta Dhatus. But also, Akaranta Dhatus are in other gana. So, those Dhatus also, other gana Dhatu also, when it takes, when you derive the Nijanta Rupam, it will take Pukkahama. And in the 10th gana, we have Akaranta Dhatu. Nya Dhatu is one Dhatu, which is Akaranta Dhatu, which will take Pukkagama. Why? Because Nich Pratya added Ni being there. Therefore, taking Pukkagama, you get the form Nyapayati. Okay. So, what to be noted is these specific dhatus listed here, when taking Nich, it means Nijanta Rupam, causative form, and Akaranda dhatus, nya dhatu, which is there in the 10th gana, which has to take nich, swarte nich, it has to take. It will take pukkahama. When preranarte also, it has to take nich only. What else? Nijanta nich when you add. Depending on the context, you have to say it is swarte or preranarte. By default, it is swarte. Preranate also same form only. So it will take pukkahama. Atam stands for Akaranta Dhatu. That is the category we are seeing. Under Ajanta Dhatavaha, Akaranta Dhatus. So what you need to remember for Akaranta Dhatus is that will take Pukkahama. Is it clear?
Yes, Ji.
Yes, Ji.
Yes.
Nothing new actually. Many things have been covered before. Under Nijanta, we have seen very elaborately this. And now also we are seeing same elaborately only. It is same thing only. Okay, it's not something new. And the dhatus listed here are all Nijanta. So that is already covered in Nijanta section. We have covered Nijanta long back. So you please check that. Dhatus, the seven dhatus. Under Nijanta, we would have seen. Nijanta section. Nijanta part we have covered that in there we have seen this. Okay. So that is not the our interest. It is only incidental. This is only incidental, therefore, which we have covered. Fine. Now Akaranta Dhatu is over. Now comes the important dhatu among the Ajanta Dhatu, which is Adanta Dhatu. Adanta Dhatavaha. What does it mean? Adanta means?
Ending
is akara.
Ending with?
Akara.
Akara.
Ending with rasva akara. Okay, adanta. Here we said akaranta. It is akaranta ending with a. Dirga letter a. Now we are saying adanta. Adanta dhatu means ending with rasva akara. Adanta, short a. Important topic here. But before that, important, enter into the important topic. We need to understand the, I'm going to cover one incidental topic, which is very important. Stani vatvam. Stani Vattam, an important topic. This we would not be able to cover in a single class. We will continue in the next class also. First, let us understand what is that. Then we will get into this derivation of Adanta Dhatu. Stani Vattam. What is Stani Vattam? See, what is Stani? Stani is?
Anga.
Stani is Anga. Why it is? Why you call it as Anga?
To be replaced, not to.
Okay. Stani. Stani is that which is replaced, right?
Yeah.
Karudiji. That which is replaced is called Stani.
Okay.
That which is, this topic is little difficult topic. You need to follow this. If you have any doubt is there, please ask. Stop me and ask. Adesha is?
That which replaces.
That which replaces is called Adesha. So, Stani Adesha. Now, Adesha, which comes in the place of Stani, which comes in the place of Stani, the Adesha, which comes in the place of Stani, acting like a Stani. The Adesha, which comes in the place of Stani, acting like a Stani. Acting like a Stani is called Stani Vat. What is Vat? Vat means Iva. Vat is Iva. Putra Vat. Gatavat, Vrikshavat, like that Vatu, here Vat is not vatu pratyaya. Vat is eva, that meaning vat pratyaya is added, right? So vat stani vat bhavati, like a stani, the adesha which comes in the place of stani, acting like a stani is called stani vat. That is, adesha behaves like a stani. So let us take one example. Asdatu, you take the example, as plus asdatu, you know, asdatu plus ta pratyaya. What is the rupam we get? I'm just taking nishta pratyaya, ta pratyaya. As is, what is the meaning of as? To be. Asti, staha, santi, asdatu. Which gana? Second gana. Okay. Adadi gana datu, asdatu. As plus ta pratyaya. What is the rupam?
Bhuta.
Bhuta.
Yes. So, as is replaced by bhu, right? As is replaced by bhu, and ta pratyaya is ta, therefore we get bhuta. Now, as is a dhatu. Is bhu a dhatu? Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. Bhu is not a dhatu, right? Bhu is the adesha.
Adesha.
Yeah, it is adesha. But
don't confuse this bhu with bhu sattayam, that bhu adhigana bhu. No, that is not a bhu here. That is different. Okay. That bhu plus ta pratyaya, when you get bhuta, that form also bhuta. That is different. Bhuta kala, etc. Here, bhu is the combination of the varna, bakara plus bhu, that is bhu. Two letters are there. It's an adesha. Don't confuse with the dhatu, bhu sattayam. That is not a astisa dhatu. Bhu is not a dhatu. So bhu is an adesha in the place of us. Us being a dhatu, therefore the adesha bhu behaves like what? Like a dhatu, as dhatu. It gets the dhatu tvam. Bhu, which is nothing but the combination of the varna, bakara plus ukara, the bhu, which gets dhatu tvam, the status of being a dhatu. Right? See, ta pratyaya, what pratyaya is this? Ta pratyaya? Is it pratyaya or not? It's a pratyaya. To what you add the tapratyaya, nishta pratyaya? To a dhatu, right?
Dhatu.
Can you add to a pratipadikam? No.
No.
You have to add nishta pratyaya, tapratyaya to a dhatu only. So, us being a dhatu, us can take tapratyaya. Now, when you replace us by bhu, this bhu also has to be a dhatu. If it is something other than dhatu, then it cannot take tapratyaya, right? So, therefore, the adesha bhu enjoys the property of asdhatu. What are the properties? What are the gunadharma of asdhatu? As is anga, as is a dhatu, and it is which gana dhatu? It is adadi gana dhatu. All the gunadharmas are enjoyed by this adesha, which is bhu. Therefore, bhu is behaves like yadhatu. It is considered to be a dhatu. Even though it is not a dhatu, because it replaces dhatu, therefore it gets all the gunadharma of asdhatu. So asdhatu, as being a dhatu, bhu also being a dhatu. Being a dhatu, therefore it can take tapratyaya. Therefore bhuta you get. Right? This is called stani vatvam. This is the best example for stani vatvam. Udaharanam for stani vatvam. Similarly, other dhatu also we can take in this, the same example. you know, when the Bru Dhatu also, what happens? Bru. Bru Dhatu, when followed by Ta Pratyaya, what is the form?
Vach, it will take Vach.
It takes Vach, yeah.
It will take Vach.
Vach, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, Bru Dhatu, these Dhatus, when followed by Ardha Dhatuka Pratyaya, will take this Adesha. Bru will be replaced by Vach. So, Bru plus Ta Pratyaya. So, what will be the form? Vach plus Ta Pratyaya will become?
Vakta.
Vakta.
I think until answer, huh? Okay. Samprasaranam happens, yes. That Vachisvapi Ajadinam Vachadatu is there, Vachadatu belonging to Adadigana. So therefore here it becomes it is Ukta, right? Samprasaranam happens,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So what is Vach? Vach is also belongs to, it belongs to Adadi Gana, second Gana only, like Bru Dhatu. But here Vach is not the Dhatu. Because it replaces Bru, Bru being a Dhatu, therefore Vach also enjoys Dhatutvam. Therefore when Ta Pratyaya is added, then Vach being a Dhatu, therefore that Dasna Visa, that Samprasaranam can happen. Therefore Ukta. So this also you can note, it's a good example. Incidentally, we got this example. That Vachisvapi Ajari and Samprasaranam we saw. That this also you can take Bru also when it is replaced by Vach under the condition. When followed by Adhidhatuka Pratyaya, that is a condition. Bru will replace by Vach. Then also it will undergo Samprasaranam. So this also can be added under Samprasaranam. I will add it later. Just note this. So now you understand what is Stani Vattvam, right? This is called Stani Vattvam. So Adesha behaving like a Stani is called Stani Vattvam. So this Adesha which replaces Stani can enjoy two Gunadharmas of this Stani. Let me write it. Adesha which replaces Stani can enjoy two things. One is Al Ashraya Dharmaha. Dharmaha means attributes or guna. Second one is Anal Ashraya Dharmaha. Anal Ashraya Dharma, Al Ashraya Dharma. Al Ashraya Dharma is the Adesha which replaces Tani can enjoy two Gunadharma. One is Al Ashraya Gunadharma. Second one is Anal Ashraya Gunadharma. It is Gunadharma attributes. Now, if the Adesha enjoys Al Ashrita Gunadharma, if the Adesha enjoys Al Ashrita Gunadharma, then the Adesha will not be Sthanivat. If the Adesha doesn't enjoy Al Ashrita Gunadharma, then it will be Sthanivat. That is, if it is Adesha is Anal Ashraya Gunadharma, then it will be Sthanivat. If it is Al Ashraya Dharma, it will not be Sthanivat. This is what we are going to discuss. For that, what is Sthanivat, you have to know. For that only, I gave this example. Asdhatu, Bhrudhatu, etc. What is Sthanivat, you know. Now, that Sthanivatvam depends on something called Gunadharma. Gunadharma means the Dharma, the properties of Sthani, the Adesha, enjoying the properties of Stani. The properties are called, attributes are called Gunadharma. when the adesha, which enjoy, which replaces tani, when it enjoys al ashraya gunadharma, that is the dharma which is dependent, ashraya means dependent, which is dependent on al. Al means varna, a letter. Al means letter. Then the adesha will not be sthanivat, will not be sthanivat. If the adesha doesn't enjoy al ashraya dharma, then it will be sthanivat. That we will discuss. We will discuss elaborately in the next class. After those discussion, then we will come to a particular niyama, the rule that will apply for the dhatus under this category, adanta dhatus in the churadigana. Okay, you will understand why we discuss all these things to discuss adanta gana. Later you will understand. First you understand what is sthanivat. Sthanivattam means what? Then this al ashraya dharma gunadharma, anal ashraya gunadharma, there are two things. Al ashraya gunadharma means that gunadharma which are ashrita on al. Al means varna. Varna ashrita vidhi. Vidhi means a rule. Rule depending on a varna. I'll give example for that. Similarly, the adesha which is just got ashrita on no al, not depends on the al of this sthani. That is anal ashraya vidhi. Anal ashraya gunadharmaha. So about this we will discuss. We will discuss in the next class. Up to this, if you have any doubts, please ask.
No, ji.
So, no, sir. Have we discussed this al ashraya gunadharma before?
No. No, sir.
No, right?
No, al ashraya vidhi.
But you said
Stanivat,
but not.
Stanivat we have discussed, right?
Stanivat we have discussed.
Just tell this some, what some, to create some curiosity, I will tell you what it is. So that next class we can pick up. Katha plus Nich, what will happen? Katha is what? Dhatu? Adanta Dhatu, right? Katha is, that A is a part of the Dhatu. Katha is a dhatu, okay? It's a four-lettered. Four letters are there. Kakara, akara. Takara, akara. Katha, adanta dhatu. Okay, katha plus nich. Now, what will happen? Nich being an adhadhatuka pratyaya. When adhadhatuka pratyaya follows adanta anga, what will happen to akara?
Akara goes away.
Akara goes away. Therefore, katha plus nich, you have. Now, what is the upada? Upada is?
Akara.
Akara. When it follows, what will happen?
Guna.
Vriddhi, right?
Vriddhi should happen, yeah.
Ka will become?
No, here it will not happen.
Here it will not happen. It
will not happen. That is why we have to discuss this.
Yeah.
If it happens, yeah, it will become Kaat.
Yeah.
Kaat plus E. You will get a form Kaati. That is not desired, right? That is not
discussed. Even
though the
kara is vanished, it's still there.
That is God. That is called Sthani Vatvam. Therefore, we need to discuss this.
Yeah, something Shanti told about Nimitta, something Nimitta.
Something you told about, okay. What is that something?
No, actually, it's for Sthani Vat, you told something about some sentence, Nimitta, or something you told.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Adeshaha anal vidau, achaparasbin purva vidau. This what is, I took two or three classes in the curriculum. It's a very important topic. Need to discuss it. I will try to do it here without sutta. Let us see. So here you can see when this katha plus nich, the upada can become dirga, that is vriddhi, because takara is there, and here it is a goes away, therefore takara is there, upada is akara, being akara. For nich follows, dirga can happen. But when it can happen, what happens is the akara which has vanished, it will pop up. No, I am there. So you don't do the upada. It will stop. So the akara which has become lopa, akara is a stani, and lopa is the adesha, right? That adesha will enjoy stani vatvam, and it will come and it will prevent upada vriddhi happening. Therefore, the stani vatvam we have to discuss. Okay, that is the context. So, adanta is this katadi gana are there. Many dhatus are there. Kata, gana, so many dhatus are there, ending with short akara. There you will see the form katayati, ganayati, like that. Why it is not katayati, ganayati? For that only we need to know this stani vattum, al ashraya vidhi, anal ashraya vidhi. So, that is the connection. Okay. So, that we will see in the next class. So, up to this. So, Tudadigana is done, right?
Yes.
So, it is.
Yes.
Okay. Do you all follow this the discussion? Is there any difficulty? Because you are all silent. I don't know whether you follow or recall.
Done.
Yeah.
So, it's
very simple. But every time we get new facts also.
Churadigana already we have seen. And Stani Vattam already we have discussed. So little more, every time little more. Okay. And when we discuss this Churadigana now, it's going to be discussed elaborately. All the Dhatus, we'll see with the Dhatu Pata, we will see. All the we'll cover all the Dhatus. I mean, if not all the Dhatus, you're not going to derive all the forms. But you know these are dhatus are there, which has akusmiya, like many things are there. We will discuss. That will cover the entire gana. So, you know all the dhatus then. Like Vadi gana, another gana, similarly Churadi gana also. And next one is Swadi gana. Swadi gana also we have covered. In fact, Swadi gana we have covered in detail. That also we will take up and do and derive different dhatus. So we'll stop here.
Now, one doubt, Vyash Dhatu, you told in this Tudadigana, the last one you told. Just can you show me that Vyash Dhatu?
Vyash
Dhatu. Saw that samprasaranam happening, no?
Tudadigana?
Yeah, Tudadigana.
Right.
Last class you gave us Vichati, and now I think you have given us Vichati.
No. I'm saying the same thing.
Is it? Just wanted to double confirm that one.
Last class I gave Vichati.
No, Vichati, just Vichati. Now I think you wrote as Vichati.
Yeah. I lost that and everything.
Which Vyach Dhatu, right?
Yeah, Vyach.
Samprasaranam.
Yeah.
I have to see under Samprasaranam.
This is the one we saw last class, but now you written separately again. I don't know why you did that.
No, separately what?
Yeah, now you, before we ending the Tudadigana, you wrote Vichati, this one.
Just a minute. Not clear.
You did again. I don't know. You thought you didn't do, but we done last class this one, but you did it again now.
Oh, that is
new PDF file.
That is under Tudadigana. Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Tudadigana only.
Yeah.
Same thing, no? Yes. Huh?
Oh, copy-paste problem. Okay, sorry.
This is new, sir.
This is a copy-paste problem, right?
Okay.
Oh, yes. I don't know why I did. This is copy-paste. Here I should have changed it. Chakara. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Copy-paste problem.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. It's good.
So can you send this file?
Yes. I copy pasted from Prichati.
Okay.
So that
okay.
Chakara, I didn't remove it, and I bent by that.
Okay.
If you do it on the board, the mistake will not come every time.
Copy. Sir, please send this file, sir, again.
Huh? Yes, sent already. Last class, he has sent everything.
Okay, I will send again. But Samprasaranam. Yeah. And Tudadigana and Churadigana. All the three files I will send you. Please go through that.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Please go through that and understand. If you have any doubts, you please ask the beginning. Whatever we discuss, that need to remember. Samprasaranam is an important topic. Okay, so stop here. Still, I am traveling, so therefore, with Karakam, when I go back to Chennai, we will continue. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavadaha.
Copy paste problem, and tell me please immediately. Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
There is no vichyati, separate form is not there. Pichayati, one form we saw. Remember?
Ah, yeah, yeah. That we saw.
That is where in Tudadigana, I think, right?
Yeah. Pichayati.
Tudadigana itself, one form we saw. Pichayati. Let me show that. I thought you are talking about that. Yeah, Pichayati. Here it is. It takes I pratyaya. You get a new dhatu, then after that you can add tip, then shab will walk in with chayati.
Yeah, 300. Okay.
Okay, here also you can note ayapratya, when you add, what you get is a new dhatu. By what rule? Sanadyantaha dhatavaha. That sanadyantaha dhatavaha, that tells you. Sanadi, etc. San pratyaya, ai pratyaya, nich pratyaya, all those pratyaya, when you add, what you get is a new dhatu. And the dhatus, new dhatu, the derived dhatu, should be treated like Vadigana. It will take shap.
Okay.
Okay. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada, Shanti.
Dhanyavada,
Shanti. Dhanyavada, Shanti. Shanti, do you have a separate book for sutras? Like all sutras covered in a book?
Book? Ashtadhyayi?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
No, what is it here?
I mean, no, I thought you have a separate book which you can follow all the sutras.
Sumatiji, I think you and Kameshwaraji and Ganesh, the three people, I mean, I have not taught, three people are there. I will start one Ashtadhyayi class. For all the people, in fact.
Okay, sure.
That is simple. That is, what do you call it? Cover all the topics quickly. Then what Ashtadhyayi class goes on now, that is elaborately, which Ramaji and other people are attending, that also you can join slowly later. Okay. So, okay. After
which
I go
day
back
you are, which day you are planning to have?
Well, soon. After I go back to Chennai, first I have to go and get my things settled there. Okay.
Oh, okay. Sure.
We'll do it. Hmm?
Yeah, thank you.
Don't worry about sutra now.
Okay.
That is why English translation I'm giving. Yeah.
Thank you, Shanti. Yeah, thank you.